Hey family, welcome back to this edition of the Opolo Diversity Solutions. It's always a pleasure having you onto this channel. Now, in today's video, we are going to be looking at this HP LaserJet Pro MFP M428DW printer. And amongst the things that we are going to look at, we are going to look at servicing the printer, look at maintenance of the printer, and as well as looking at the repairing session of the printer. So without wasting any of our time, let's dig into the video. So let us explore and see exactly what challenges this printer is having. Then after that, we can then do the servicing, repair and maintenance of this very printer. So for this particular printer, let me try to photocopy and see how it behaves. Copy document here and then copy. It's copying. You realize that it gives some weird sound with the rollers. Let me try to proceed. Hope you hear that sound. And it gives us an error message here to load paper in tray. Let's try to say okay and see. Then it gives us a paper jam error message. So the message reads, paper is jammed in the cartridge area. So let's try to see the problem this printer is having. It has, it always brings paper jam here. Let me try to remove the cartridge. In case you don't know how to replace cartridge, you can check out on the videos that we made about how to change cartridge. So you see, this one has, always gets paper jam in the middle of the cartridge area. So our we need to see exactly what causes this problem, and we see how we can rectify this. So you see, every time we try to print or photocopy, it gives us this error message of paper jam. This is the paper that is jammed in. So let's see how we can, let's first try again. Let's first put back the cartridge. Put back the cartridge and see whether the problem is repetitive. So I'll start. Printer with this initializing. So let's try to copy. And the job is in progress. Oops, still gives us that paper jam error message, meaning that there is a problem with the rollers that transport the papers through the printing areas. So you see, it still has those problems of jamming. Now we need to find a way of rectifying this problem. So first things first, we are going to start by servicing the printer, and we're going to do that by cleaning it up, getting rid of the dust by blowing, using this blowing. Yeah. So we are going to do that, and we're going to try to open up the inner parts using our normal usual Phillips screwdriver. So let's dig into the video right away. So always remember, first things, you should always disconnect power off the printer before you do any servicing to off the printer. So I'm disconnecting this, of course, after switching it off using the power button, which is here. So for this exact printer, it has a screw behind here that we need to first check out. Has a screw. Let's first get rid of the trays. Let's remove the paper tray, put it aside. There is still the paper which is in the jam area. Let's remove the cartridge, also put it aside. Let's first remove this paper jam.
that would clear the pathway. So once you remove the paper jam, there is a screw here.
Yeah, that we need to unscrew first. Let's just get it off.
This one here.
Then before we proceed, let me first show you something. We have below this printer, we have these rollers, the ones responsible for transporting the paper, the print paper, through these various printing area sections. So these are the ones that pull the papers from the tray. And in case there is always the paper jam, in case they fail to push the papers, that means the paper is bound to jam inside. So if you're doing servicing or checking up, you have to consider replacement in case they are worn out. So these ones look quite old. We don't know. We need to check them out. So in case they are old, you have to replace them into new ones. So those are the basic areas where you're supposed to look at. And there is this tray that supports the paper once it's transported into the printing area of the inside. So let's proceed with our servicing and repair. So after removing the screw, let's see how we can open this cover. Let's open this. You have to do this gently so that you don't. Let's try to open this part also. There are some locks inside that you have to remove. Same applies to the behind side. You have to do this gently. You have to be careful while removing, or rather unlocking, these locks because they're a bit tricky and sensitive. You have to do it careful so that you don't break them at any time. Oops. So you can see the dirt
You can see the dust that is inside. So you realize that this dust is, or rather this printer has taken a long time without being cleaned, or rather serviced from the inside. That's why it's developing those issues of paper jamming. There's too much dust inside, you see? You see? Uh-oh. Do not do that at home, you know. So let's try to open up also the other side and see how we can proceed with our servicing bit of it. And also do the same for this side. Removing this. Oops, you realize that this side also has some bit of dirt, some bit of dust. So let's do. Let's get rid of these screws also from the behind side here. And the two. This is one. And the second one here. This is a manual screwdriver, Phillips screwdriver that I'm using. So you guys have to bear with me. I'm done removing these screws. We try them from the under to unlock that clip that takes the tray over the papers. This is it. Put it aside also. Now here we are. Okay, so next we unscrew these fuser screws also from the upper side here. That is one. We also unscrew the upper screw here for the fuser. There is two. Then once we are done with the upper screws, there is this fuser connector, which is down here. We need to first disconnect it off from the board before we remove the fuser. And we do that by pressing the, disconnect it. The cable has a pathway here where it passes, so you can either, we can just decide, in order not to lose track of the cable, we can just unscrew the whole bit which is this other screw here. So that will remove the entire part that houses the cable path. It's quite hard, but let's just remove the cable. Okay, once we have the cable path, the cable disconnected, we can then flip it from this other side. There's this handle that connects to the fuser. We need to also disconnect it so that we get the fuser unit free. And let's first remove this. Let's first unscrew this. Screw this. Of course, this is from the under. This is from under. This is the part that we need to first secure and put aside. So once we are done from that that angle, there is one other screw inside here holding this other part that we need to disconnect. So let's just disconnect it. That's the screwdriver, and this is the part that we have removed, so we also secure it. Be careful, it has a spring here that has to be kept intact. It has to be kept intact, so you have to be careful this doesn't fall off. It has to be kept intact because it also helps with the paper movement. So let's proceed, my brother and sister. Then there is, I don't know whether you can be able to see those, these other two screws from the inside, this and this, that hold this entire fuser unit. So let's get them out also. Man, filming this thing is also not easy. You have to be careful and see that you view. Trying to view. Okay, let me just use this. After flipping it, let me just try to unscrew it from this other side. This is the screw we are interested in. Second one of this other opposite side, it's here. We also need to unscrew it, make it a little loose. So that's it. And there is this lock that we need to remove. You can just remove it gently. It has its only, it has its trail here where you, in case you're putting it back, you just fit it gently back there smoothly. So let's put it aside also. So once we are done there, we then now, you see there is this let me first try to show you. There is this handle that holds assists in the transportation of these papers. You have to first unlock it gently, and once you unlock that, you can be able to pull out the fuser. But before you pull it out, it also has these connectors here that you need to connect, disconnect off the board, and you have to do that gently and gently. So we need to disconnect these fuser connectors gently. You can just flip this, and also with this. So once we are done, we can then gently remove our fuser. So this is our fuser unit that we need to check thoroughly and also see how we can replace it in case it has some errors. You see, papers have been always jamming through here. So we need to clean this thing up very well. In case it needs replacement, we can see how we can replace it. It's always available. The spares are available on Amazon and any other local stores near you. So let's try to clean this up and see how we can proceed to see how we can fix this or printer here.
Now this fuser unit, or rather the fuser unit itself, is a heated roller that melts the toner particles onto the page, the print page of the paper, and while passing through it, and it ensures that that toner does not fall off the paper once it's printed through the printer and removed out. So it does a better role. Now this one of ours here, when you shake, there are some particles in there, that there's that sound showing that it has particles. So you realize that this one has some broken parts, like you see, that we need to replace. So let's see how we can clean this fuser unit up. And I have with me a brush here that I can use to get rid of the dirt. And also I have a lint-free towel that I can use to get rid of the dirt. And also I have a cleaning foam here, universal cleaning foam agent here. So these are the things that I'm using at the moment to clean this unit. And without wasting any of our time, let's just try to get this fume, or rather foam, and just apply a little. Don't apply too much, just apply a little and soak it so that it's just wet a bit. So I'll just clean it, wipe the entire surface. You realize that there is a lot of dirt in here. Let me see if you can be able to see. You see that the dirt inside as I try to roll. So that's what we are trying to get rid of. Sometimes these fuser units get old and they need replacement. But for my case here, I'm not replacing. I'm just doing servicing. So in case you want to replace, you can always replace. In case you find yours faulty and broken, you can always replace. Sometimes they just wear off and they need replacement. They're just too old to serve. But in case yours is not old enough and your machine is a new one, you can always just do a servicing. Do a thorough clean of the unit. So let's try to get rid of this dirt. Get rid of the dirt. Get rid of the dirt. Gently, but surely. We'll also get our blower to blow off the dust. Disconnected. Try to connect the power. Forgive me for the noise. This one is to enable us to get rid of the dirt from the inside the fuser unit. Hope you forgive me for that noise, but I mean, it's worth it, right? If you need something good, you have to bear with the noise and the dust.
Okay, so once we are done with this, we can now then proceed to clean up the entire printer and also ensure that we get rid of all the dirt. So let me resolve this. And here is our baby that needs to be clean. So you see all this dust? I need to get rid of it by blowing it up. I get my blower, rather blowing machine, and get rid of the dust. Cover. Try to open this cover also so that we get access to the interior and blow it off also. Blow the dust away. Is done, we can then start wipe cleaning on top using our lid free towel here. But before we do that, there is this roller that I wanted to show you, and we also have to, let me see if I can show it to you here. This one here, we have to first get it out and see how we can clean it up. Sometimes it also delays it, or rather jams the paper. So for it, the only way we can remove it is by, let me see if I can do that, just squeeze. You see here, there is that handle that you need to first squeeze and then pull it out. I don't know how I can show you without distracting. Anyway, let me this is the part that you need to press, then you remove that roll. So I will try to press it and then remove it. So yes, remove it. This is it. We need to clean this as well. We need to clean this as well. Sometimes in case it's worn out, you need to replace. But in my case here, it seems to be okay. So in case it's a worn out piece, you can always replace it. So let me just put it back. After cleaning it, see if I can show you how you put it back. Putting it back is the same. You just here at the extreme corner, you first enter this extreme corner. Once it's joined in, you can just then push it slightly in, just like that.
And it's firmly fitted well. So let's proceed by cleaning up the computer, or rather the printer. Okay, so I'll get my little free towel, shake well my cleaning foam agent, and I will spray it onto the towel, then I will wipe. And this will help me clean the entire printer so well, so that it can look like it is even new. This is the cleaning that we're talking about. You have to be careful that you don't, and some people you can use cleaning liquid, but when you're doing that, you have to be careful and ensure that you are not spraying any inner cables or connectors. You have to be very keen when you're doing that. Sides, you see how dirty the towel is becoming, meaning the printer was too dirty for life. Again, I can put back my cleaning foam, clean all the sides very well. Cooling fan also is dirty, needs some cleaning, some thorough cleaning. Okay, once that is done, I'll try this side also, the behind side. This is phase number one of cleaning. We are focusing on the interior before we do the final one of the exterior side. So once we are done, we can then proceed putting back our fuser unit. And in case it says a story of replacement, we can replace our fuser unit. Let us proceed. So I'll get my fuser unit here. Get my clean fuser unit. Check it very well and ensure that it is fitted in. Ensure that it is very clean. Forgetting this handle here. Once it's fitted, we can then connect these connectors here.
make sure that everything is aligned properly into its pathway, just like that. We can then proceed and put back the screws. Proceed and put back our screws. Don't forget the screws you got from here. You have to be careful. You have to be careful so that you don't forget the screws. All the screws put back into the very position where you got them. That is done, and then also align our cable here, fuser cable, wire connector, power connector, and then connect it to you through its pathway onto the board, which is here. Ensure that the pathway is followed very well. And the paper, the cable is not out of the line. So that's it. That is it. There is this our cover here that you're not supposed to forget. The one that covers the connector. The one that covers the fuser connector. Let's put it to its pathway gently. Ensure that it is well connected. Ensure that it is connected very well. So once that is done, we can then put these two also back. Put these two screws back. That they are tightened very well. Let us fix this one as well back into its position. And where is the screw falling? Hey, screw. What are you falling? You screwdriver, screw. Okay. sure that the screw is fitted in very well.
To avoid problems when we have this under.
We have this part here that we need to put back gently into its position, then get this screw. Sure that the screw is tightened very well. Oops. So once that is done, we can then get this other part. But before we do that, we are going to clean it. We need to first clean it also. Clean it also thoroughly, get rid of all the dust. Of any dust. See, there are these two angles, or rather two joints that need to be fixed inside. So before you close that thing, it has to always go there first. So let's first remove this, and from the top you ensure that this part enters here. And this one also enters very well inside. Once that enters, we can get our two screws, this and this. And then tighten the two screws, that and this here. Once that is done, we can then attach that there, put that aside, and then we clean the other parts also. You see this one? That needs to be cleaned thoroughly. So with my cleaning foam, I'll clean it. You can even wash this because this one is just mere plastic. You can wash it using liquid water. So this is too dirty for life. There's a little dust. But let's clean it. Let's clean it thoroughly. Roll. You see how the towel is now looking? Too dirty for life, man. It's okay. We have to clean this. Our printer gets back to life. So that our printer gets back to normal life. Almost there, bro. Almost there. Once that is done, you can go on to this next one also. Now we are focusing on the interior. Bit of it. We've not done this other exterior side, so we need to first deal with the interior. Then after that, we can then clean the exterior bit of it. How does it look? Just comment and let me know how it looks. And get rid of all the dirt. Look how the towel is now looking. Too dirty for life. Let us now put back our cover, our exterior covers, and proceed right away. So we on the behind side. Make sure that this one goes over the fits in very well. Or if not, you can start from this side.
sure that all the locks fit in very well. Then for this we have our screw. We have our screw that goes here. Then this one also, we fix it. Also, ensure that the locks all are fitted in very well. Careful. We are supposed to start from behind. Start from there. Supposed to start from here. Now this one is low. You have to be careful so that you don't mess up a thing. be super careful so that you don't mess up. So that you don't mess up on the lock. On the lock. Oops. So there we are. We get, then get our tray. We need to clean our tray as well. So next is to clean the exterior, and this time around I'm using a different towel because this one is too dirty for life. And I use my cleaning foam. With my lid free towel, and I'll clean thoroughly. Everything is handled well. Clean on all the sides. Clean on all the sides. All sides, clean on all sides. So once that is done, we can then now put back our cartridge into the cartridge area. Put back the cartridge into our cartridge area, and then close the printer very well. Once the printer is closed, we then connect our power source. Connect our power source. This is our power source here. Let's see what message it's giving us. Asking us to load paper. Let's see if we have some plain papers here, which we load into the donut tray. Trying to adjust the tray for A4 size. Let's try to modify the size, paper size. We can modify the paper any size, or rather we've put A4, we can choose A4. F4 paper type, any type. So after loading paper, we can then try to do a test and see exactly what the outcome could be. So let me just photocopy this test. At this point, you can kindly subscribe to the video over to the channel. So let's try to test this. Let's try to copy this and see the output. Copy document. realize that the sound has reduced a bit. The sound of the room has reduced. This is our output. So if you try to just check the difference, this is the original that we've photocopied, and this is the output. So I think we are having a success.
And that's it for this video. In case you've come a long way up to here, please, I appreciate you. Thank you so much for the support. And for those who haven't subscribed yet, kindly feel free to hit that subscription button and the notification bell so that you get all the updates anytime we upload any of these fixes. Ubuntu Diversity, solutions to excellency. See you in the next video. Cheers.